It has been a partly cloudy day with light to moderate southeasterlies. Temperatures above average, reaching 26 to 28 degrees across our western suburbs, including Penrith and Campbelltown, 25 in Gosford and Terry Hills, and 27 in the city with 60 to 70% humidity. We've seen showers across much of the state today, rain and storms increasing this evening. Bathurst, Orange and Parkes picking up 7 millimetres, 5 falling in Armidale. And tonight there is a storm warning for heavy rain for parts of the central tablelands, the north and central west, the Hunter and the Far West. Temperatures reaching into the 30s today right across the northwest region, while coastal areas range from 22 in Newcastle all the way up to 28 in Grafton. Tomorrow, a trough over the eastern inland region will maintain rain and storms in the north and over southern Queensland. Tomorrow, Brisbane's heading for a partly cloudy day, 27, partly cloudy and 26 in Canberra and Melbourne, while the heat wave continues in Perth, heading for a sweltering 40 degrees. Tomorrow, the rain will move to the west of the state with the potential for up to 25 millimetres. The coast could also see some showers, but they will be very light, if anything. Cooler temperatures along the coast with expected tops of 23 in Wollongong and Coffs Harbour, while further inland, Dubbo and Mudgee are on track for around 25 degrees, 32 across the Riverina. Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow. There is a 40% chance of showers, most likely in the evening, with light to moderate southerly winds. If that rain arrives, we're expecting 1 to 2 millimetres across the Sydney Basin. Heading for a warm top of 28 in Penrith, 27 for Liverpool and Campbelltown, 25 for Gosford and the city, and a top of 22 degrees in Cronulla. Let's take a look ahead, and the unsettled weather will continue for the next week with up to 3 millimetres of rain on Friday, 25 degrees, up to 8 millimetres of rain on Saturday, 26, warming up to 30 degrees on Sunday with potentially heavier rain next week. Those overnight lows range from 19 down to 16 degrees. In our west, we could see anything from 1 to 80 millimetres of rain between now and this time next week. So clearly the model's still unsure about how much rain we'll actually see. It will get very warm though over the weekend, 29 on Saturday, 33 degrees on Sunday, while those nights will range from lows of 18 down to 16 degrees, Georgie.
Hello again. There was no shortage of spring sunshine today, but no matter how hard it worked, it still couldn't push the city past 20 degrees. It peaked at just 18.6. But most of our suburbs recorded maximums starting with a 2. Scoresby and Yarra Glen did the best, reaching 23. It's been warm again through the north with maximums in the high 20s and low 30s, but there were some lightning strikes around Mildura this afternoon. There's intense heat on the other side of the country. Perth reached 37 degrees today, and the heat is set to ramp up even further tomorrow. It's heading for 40, and should it reach 40.4, it'll be its hottest November day on record. A sunny top of 20 degrees for Hobart. Sydney could get a shower or two on its way to 25, but there'll be dry skies in Brisbane and a top of 27. Back home, most of the state is expected to stay in double figures overnight. Then northern districts will have another day in the high 20s and the low 30s. And temperatures will take a slight jump through the south, mostly the low to mid 20s. It'll be mostly sunny, but there could be a few showers and storms in the northwest later in the day. And they do have the potential to deliver heavy rain and damaging winds. Melbourne's in for another mild night with minimums of 11 and 12 degrees and 13, and there'll be cloud about early on and then a mostly sunny day with temperatures quite a bit higher than today. 29 degrees at Coldstream, 28 at Ringwood, mostly 26 and 27 elsewhere. Geelong will also be warmer than today. After its low of 13, it's heading for 23, and after a low of 14, the city's expected to reach 26. But it will become a little unsettled after that. 28 on Friday, some showers from the afternoon. Showers and possible storms will continue into Saturday, and they're likely to be on and off and a top of 27. Cooling on Sunday, 19 degrees, up to 10 millimetres of showers, 17 degrees on Monday, and it's just a sprinkle on Tuesday, a top of 19, and then a cloudy 21 next Wednesday. Tomorrow, the city will finally warm up after a low of 14. It should reach 26 with some early cloud clearing for a sunny afternoon. afternoon.
Let's have a look at the radar firstly. Widespread showers and storms again. Heaviest falls down through the southern downs and the scenic rim with 20 to 30 millimetres. And there were up to 30 millimetres also recorded around Deception Bay today. On to temperatures now. And 26 for Coolangatta, the Gold Coast, Redlands. Redcliffe and the Sunshine Coast, 27. Brisbane, Ipswich and Archerfield, 28 degrees. The weather map, a trough over WA, the Northern Territory, Queensland and inland New South Wales will extend down into Victoria and South Australia, bringing rain and storms. More of it. Capitals, a scorcher for Perth and 40 degrees. Late showers in Adelaide. A shower or two for Sydney. Showers and storms, Darwin. Queensland, a few showers across the north coast extending all the way down to the Whitsundays. Just a slight chance of a shower for the Capricornia, Wide Bay and Burnett. Afternoon storms inland, especially for the central west, with heavier falls down through the Maranoa. Here in the southeast, a few scattered showers, possible inland thunderstorms, probably less than 5 millimetres over the next 24 hours, so becoming lighter. Daytime temperatures, we're looking at mid to high 20s. Moreton Bay, northeasterlies 10 to 15 knots, tending easterly, while Brisbane tomorrow, the best chance of showers will be in the morning, easing back throughout the day in a top of 27. 7-day outlook, well, partly cloudy skies, slight chance of a shower and high 20s for Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Showers returning next week. Ipswich, cloudy with a slight chance of a shower each day, Friday and over the weekend. Monday, 33 degrees with showers returning and rain for Tuesday. For the Gold Coast, there is the slight chance of a shower Friday and Saturday, 26 each day. Showers returning late on Monday and increasing for Tuesday. And on the Sunshine Coast, partly cloudy skies and a possible shower Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Showers should return late Monday. It will be a warm one back to work Monday, but then showers and thunderstorms as we get into Tuesday.
Bright blue skies in the city still this evening. We're around the 20 degree mark at the moment. Earlier today we reached 25 and a half. Through the suburbs, well, if you live in the foothills, you would have noticed it was pretty windy overnight. Those gully winds really are ramping up. And through the south too, in fact, at Selix Hill, we had winds gusting at 76 k's an hour. It was 23 at Norlunga today. Storms have re-emerged in our northeast with outback rain at Moomba, Maree and Lee Creek. It was 32 at Port Pirie. The Riverland has been just on the edge of the storm zone with 29 at Renmark today, and it's been windy through the York Peninsula this afternoon with 27 at Kadena. Have a look on the charts tomorrow. You can see the blue blobs are bubbling up throughout SA. That is this stormy system that we're watching very closely as it edges towards Adelaide too. Those storms have turned severe and brought heavy rain to regional New South Wales and Queensland. While in the west, Perth is already breaking November heat records and is headed for 40 degrees tomorrow. Tomorrow, we can really see those storms working their way through SA. It's pretty widespread, and some towns could see the storms during the day, like Port Augusta and Port Pirie, in fact, where they could turn severe. Nirriutspur is more so looking at nighttime storms, while Renmark could see storms and very heavy rainfall anytime from late morning. So lots of warnings. Earlier today, a huge chunk of the northeast was under a severe storm alert. Now it's reduced to a smaller area near the border. With this rain coming in, we have downy mildew alerts for the Mount Lofty Ranges and other grape growing regions, and winds are remaining strong on the waters in many regions. So warnings in place there from the west across to the southeast. On metro waters, we're looking at southeasterlies reaching 25 knots south of Port Norlunga in the early morning and seas around a metre. So tomorrow during the day around Adelaide, it should be pretty fine and a touch warmer too with 28 degrees at Elizabeth. It's at night time where we could see the showers turning up and the beginning of some thunderstorms. In the city, we've got 27 degrees during the day and then, of course, listening out for those storms at night time. And then that overnight period, Thursday night into Friday morning, is when we could see those storms really coming to life. On Friday, we could see anything up to 15 millimetres, but it all just does depend on where those storms decide to fire up. Saturday, looking showery, but not as intense. And then on Sunday, we're more so looking at just overcast conditions and drying out as we move towards the beginning of next week.